Now we will move on to the final topic, the Snort. So Snort is again is the open source network intrusion detection and prevention system. And there's a who used the Snort? You used it. You used it. All right. Right. You maybe used it a while ago. Right. So we will just recap. You know what is Snort and how to run it. Right. So there's three different modes, which is sniffer, and sniffer is just, you know, looking at the network, and as a packet logger, you're gonna print to the packet into the log file, load the packet into log file, and NIDS. I usually use only for the NIDS mode or NIPS mode. So difference is basically just if it's a IDS network and intrusion detection system mode, it just makes the alert. That's the mode. But when you run this Snort as a IPS mode, what means is it's basically when wire Snort run and if there is a pattern match, it actually drops the packet. So one thing important thing is in order to drop packet, that means the Snort must run at the boundary of your network. If you're already running on your machine, then it's kind of, you know, as an IP doesn't make any sense because it's already on your machine, right? So there is a that difference between the IDS and the IPS. And Snort comes with actually different layers of the pre-detection processing. There's like a FRAC 3, stream 5, and RPC decoder and HTTP inspect. And these here, FRAC 3 and then stream 5 deals with the layer 3 and then 4, right? The IP layer and the IP4 layer. Others is the application protocol specific, right? So if traffic is not HTTP, then you will not go to the RPC, but there's no reason for that. However, it's configurable, right? Basically, it says which port do you want to, you know, for to which application decoder, you can configure it, right? And some of this, you know, preprocessor actually depends on the other. For example, HTTP inspect cannot run by itself without the TCP, you know, desegmentation here. So stream 5, you should make, you know, this segment or the segmented, you know, segment, and then you give it to the higher level decoder. Alright, and how the look Snort rule looks like, there's actually two types. One, the text rule, which is look like very here. Actually, here actually missing the SID rule option. There must SID is required. And there's also SO rule, call it as SO rule, but there's a rule you can write in the C, actually C code. So the purpose of this in the C code is there's some case you need to do either looping by just doing looping or some much, you know, complex operation basically, rather than just simple some, you know, pattern match, then you can write as a C rule. And here again, rule header is start with an alert. Or actually, another common word is drop. If it's alert, you just make the alert and then done with done. But sometimes it, when you run it as a prevention mode, you need to put it as a drop rule, right? And here you can put either IP or TCP, which layer you actually wanna look at. If it's a TCP, then this content match comes as a TCP payload match, right? And source IP, source port, destination IP, destination port. Then other options will explain more here. And here, rule option, this is the old rule body here. You can put message, content, and there's some content modifier. You can more specify whether content should be case sensitive or case insensitive. You can specify those details. And there's a rule option. And I will not mention all here. However, you can do PCRE, you know, the PCRE means PERL, something with a regular expression. Sorry?
Regular expression.
Oh, there you go. Oh, yeah, I have it. PERL compatible regular expression. Yeah, that's me, the PCRE. But you must have an SIDC here, otherwise you will end up having some error message from the snort.